days we fill our supermarket trolleys. We pile them without really thinking about it. Not so long ago we didn't have the same wide-ranging choice. The great challenge was to keep food fresh, to give it a longer shelf life. The revolution began here in Sweden, in a place not so far from here. Tetra Pak is the biggest packaging supplier on the planet, with a turnover last year of $13.5 billion. Heading up the technology team is Lawrence Mott. The company's success, he tells us, is based on the innovation, aseptic technology.
It's a technology whereby you simultaneously sterilise the milk or the juice, for example, and the packaging material. So it doesn't matter if that package lives in a room temperature. It doesn't have to be refrigerated. Because there's no bacteria in there, it can't spoil.
That's the revolution. Aseptic technology, rapidly preheating and cooling the liquid. Tetra Pak gave us long life milk.
It launched a whole new class and category of product, and this allowed you to manufacture a package in one location and ship it many hundreds or even thousands of kilometres to another location.
I began thinking about packaging foods, especially milk, right from the very beginning.
The big idea came from the Swedish packaging pioneer Ruben Rausing in the 1940s. He began with a shape you only ever saw in geometry class, the tetrahedron.
It allows you to pack product without any air, so it makes it very, very efficient in terms of the materials used and to distribute this around the world. Here is a tube. It's continuously filled here, and as it's moving through the machine, we simply grip and seal the tube, and it's a continuous motion. It's fantastically simple. It's the foundation of what we do today.
It was the first step towards sterile packaging and aseptic technology. The tetrahedron was followed by other shaped packages, so far about 230 different types. They sell the packages, but also the machines that make them. Pride of place in Tetra Pak reception, this prototype filling machine from 1946. All cogwheels, bicycle chains and wood. And this is its gleaming modern equivalent, capable of making and filling 250,000 cartons a day.
This is what we believe is the fastest injection moulding machine in the world.
Constant innovation is fundamental to the company. Refining the packaging, refining these machines. And it all goes back to Rausing himself.
That they will survive and be of importance only if they are continuously innovative.
Many of the philosophies that used to guide him daily in his work, such as, you know, a package should save more than it costs, it lives with us every day.
Ruben Rausing died in 1983, reputedly the richest man in Sweden. His spirit of innovation lives on. Tetra Pak cartons are now part of all our lives. The company has helped change the way we shop, indeed, the way we consume food. It still does.